usher to escort you out during the applause between musical selections. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Music for percussion. You'll see a variety of world instruments here, as well as classical percussion. And you'll also hear some different modes that are closer to modes that you'd hear in like Indonesian music or gamelan, as well as a lot of polymeter and polyrhythms. So here we go. This is Harrison Modes. Thank you.
Thank you.
After that, we're going to just need a few minutes to get instruments off stage. We're going to set up our World Percussion Afro-Cuban set. This piece here was directed by Jameson Maciel. So here's Jameson. Here we go. Thank you.
All right, so this is, we're gonna do a suite of Afro-Cuban music that is from the Bantu linguistic group. So there's a bunch of subgroups that play this type of music. Originally, it was enslaved in Cuba in between the 15th and 17th century. So these are some old repertoire here that survived in Cuba. And there's four pieces we're gonna play, and we're gonna start with a piece called Garabato. Styles in Cuba, like the wawanko and the rumba, which had this kind of congolese effect from the yuca. All right, here we go. Let's make our switch. right, we're going to do the third piece in the trilogy, the four pieces. This is called Makuta. And what can I say about Makuta? It's not really practiced anymore today, the religion, the Makuta religion, but it's still performed on stages in Havana and elsewhere in Cuba. So here is Makuta. Tembe, tembe Maria, tembe, tembe Vida. Two piece is called Palo, and we're going to start with a couple of prayer songs in the Palo tradition.
Thank you. Quimbambula, quimbambula, buena noche, quimbambula, quimbambula, son las horas. Quimbambula, quimbambula, buena noche, quimbambula, quimbambula, son las horas. Oya ya po, oya ya canawa, oya ya canawa, oya ya canawa. Oh yeah, yeah, Kanawa. Oh yeah, yeah, Kanawa. Oh yeah, yeah, Kanawa. Oh yeah, yeah, oh. Every night, I'm not dying. When they come,
man, I got to do a head count to get us started here, you know. It's like, make sure we got everybody on stage. Everybody, thank you for being here. Thank you for coming out on a rainy night. Is it still raining out there? I don't even know. All I know is when I was coming in with all my stuff, it rained the hardest. That's all I know. So, everybody, thank you for being here. It always feels good to play here in Fulkerson Hall. This hall is the hall that the Calypso Band got its start in so many years ago. How many years ago? 38 years ago. So, the first song we're going to play for you tonight is a classic jam from Trinidad and Tobago, the nation state that this art form originated in, by one of the most significant calypsonians of his generation, David Rutter. This one's called Bacchanal Lady. Thank you. you very much, everybody. Your Hooter solos on that one. You heard Eric over here on the double seconds. Eric. And you heard Patrick over here on the double tenors. Man, we're going to keep it going with the classic jams here tonight. This song written by Len Boogsy Sharp, you're going to hear a couple pieces by him tonight. And this is just a classic song the band's been playing ever since the tune was written. This one's called Sarah. And this one we're going to feature the youngest member of our band as our soloist right over here. Thomas, I know you told me before, I was saying you're 16, you're 15, is that it? 15-year-old! So, you know, I'm not saying that to embarrass him, I'm saying that because I'm like in awe of it, man. I only wish I was doing this when I was 15! How good I'd be now if I only was, you know? But everybody, this tune's a classic jam. Again, the great tune by Len Boogsy Sharp. Sarah. Thank you. Thank you so much, everybody. Let's hear it for Thomas right here. All right. Great job, man. All right. We're going to change it up a little bit right now and play a bossa nova. There's like so much I could say, but what I'll say is this. If you've listened to any of the bossa novas coming out of Brazil that really, you know, really established that style worldwide, you've heard the beautiful singer Astrucci Alberto sing. And she passed away this past year. I believe it was June of 2023. I told the band today, I thought she was living in Philadelphia. We could have gone and visited her. Who knew? You know, but she passed away in June of 23. And we're going to play a tune called Astrud. This tune was written by Basia. Basia is a European artist, you know, not a Brazilian artist, but it's an artist that, you know, is just a phenomenal artist. She grew up really admiring and modeling her vocal style after Astrud, and her very first record, when she signed her first record contract, very first record she put out, this was her first hit. It's a tune called Astrud, and it's our tribute to Astrud Gilberto. Thank you. We heard so many solos on that one. First by Patrick over here. Patrick. Second, Andrew right up here. Andrew. Third, right here, Julian. Julian. And then finally, my left-hand person, right up here, MJ. We're gonna play a song now that the band actually hasn't played in quite a few years, but it's an oldie. It's an old one, and it's a song that I composed for the band way back in 1993. Yes, I was alive. Yes, I was alive. I took my very first trip to Trinidad in 1993 to play in the Panorama competition down there during the carnival. Just was a phenomenal experience. One of my colleagues, who you'll hear a little bit later in the show and who you saw in the first half, Howie Kaufman, accompanied me down there on that trip. We had the time of our lives. But, you know, it was intimidating, you know, going down to the land of Pan for the first time in 93. There wasn't a lot of people from the United States going down and playing, and you know, you go down there and play and show your utmost respect to the art form and to the culture and to the people, and still they're looking at you like, can this person play? You know, it's like, it's an experience that, you know, we'll never forget. And there was this one young man in the band that we were playing in. The band we were playing in was the Hummingbird Steel Groove of St. James, Trinidad. And man, it's like his name, first name was Tony. For the whole time I was down there, I thought his last name was Painter because everybody called him Painter, Painter. Here, it turned out he was a painter. You know, it was his nickname. They just called him Painter. But, you know, he was a cool guy, and he befriended us, befriended me. And I just heard, he just kept, every time I was like, oh man, he's like, everything's all right, man, everything's all right, everything's all right, everything's all right. He's just repeating that over and over again. So this phrase just lodged in my head, everything's all right. So, you know, this song kind of just came out of that one right there. So it's like, it's my tribute, my thank you to the people of Trinidad and Tobago here, my tune, everything's all right. And you know what? It is. It is. Okay, so thank you. Here we go.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, everybody. You heard a couple of cello solos on that one. Oh my God, you don't hear cello solos that often. First one, Raymond right over here. Raymond. Second one, Jameson right over here. So we're just going to keep it coming here. We're going to get into a couple of panorama tunes now. We got a couple of them for you. This one, beautiful tune by Ray Holman called If We Really Want. We've been working on this tune for, I guess we started working on it last spring. You know, we're continuing it. This fall, we're going to continue it till we learn almost the whole thing. I think it's a 12-minute long song, so we're giving you our rendition of it here tonight. It is a beautiful piece. And, you know, Ray, maybe some of you were here at our show last spring where we brought Ray Holman up from Trinidad. You know, he's a special artist who has written a lot of, you know, great classic songs throughout his lifetime. But a couple of his most important ones are ones where he really shows the love that he has for his people, for his culture, and for the future of Trinidad and Tobago. And this tune right here, If We Really Want, you know, it's basically about bettering yourself, bettering your community, bettering the world, you know, and the messages, you know, you can do it. You just got to want to do it first. The first step is wanting to do it. You want to do it, you can do it. You know, so that's the theme behind this song, and I keep trying to channel that in my mind. I hope you feel those positive vibes. Ray also really tried to represent a lot of the different peoples of Trinidad and Tobago. So he wrote this, there you'll hear this section in this piece that kind of sounds almost like an Arabic Middle Eastern kind of groove in the middle of the piece. And, you know, he introduced that section in the piece to recognize the contributions of all the people of Trinidad and Tobago who have had such a great influence on their music. So, yeah, I could talk forever. I'm not going to, if we really want. All right. What a tune. What a tune. What a tune. We're going to play a song now that might be one of the most recorded Afro-Cuban tunes of all time. So, you know, this one, everybody's done it. When that happens with a tune, there's got to be a reason. You know, the reason is it's a classic, one of the classics of all time by Mongo Santa Maria, Afro Blue. So, you know, there's so many different ways to interpret this song, and we've done different versions over the years. Every time we redo a song, we try to do it a little bit different here. This year, ask my colleague Howie Kaufman right here to come join us. Gonna feature Howie and his bodies on this one. You're gonna hear a lot of soloists on this one as well, you know. When we play this tune, I think of so many things, but you know, what I think of for myself is getting to meet Mongo Santa Maria when he played in the JVD Theater, you know, like many years ago now. I mean, Mongo's passed away, but you know, it's just like, I usually don't like make it a point to like get backstage and like meet the artists. You know, I'm usually trying to be super cool about that stuff. Man, not this time, man. I was getting back there, I was introducing myself, I was shaking his hand, I was telling him how much, you know, he's done for this world, and I have a picture that I look at in my office all the time of me and Mongo backstage there. The guy's got a grin from ear to ear. He was just a regular person, and that's what made it all the better. Very humble, very thankful, and just love to play. So, you know, that's what we channel when we play his music right here. It's just the guy loved to play, and we love to play his music. So here we go, Afro Blue.
Fuck!
Tune of the night. I'm looking at the clock over there. I looked at that one first. I'm like 11:15 already. That's the right one. It's 10:15, so we're pretty good. But it's a great one. It's a great one. And it's a tune by Len Booksy Sharp. Name of the tune, Misbehave. It's just crazy how, you know, I tried to remember when this tune was from, so I looked it up today. 1997, I mean, that's like a long time ago now. The video of the band playing the tune is some really, you know, grainy VHS thing. You know, it's pre-cell phone in everybody's pocket kind of time, you know. But the tune itself, absolutely timeless, you know. Booksy Sharp is just... You know, there are no words to describe the talent, the creativity, the heart, and the spirit of Len Booksy Sharp. I mean, some of the best steel pan music that I've ever heard in my life came right out of that human being's mind, you know, right out of his mind, right into the pans. So, you know, it's a pleasure to be able to play his music. It's an honor to be able to play his music. I know that some people in Phase 2 in Trinidad are watching our live stream tonight, you know, so this is for everybody. I mean, we're playing for you right here, you know, and thank you for being here, everybody. Thank you for the support, you know, thank you so much. You know, but it's like in this age of live streaming, you never know who's out there. So whoever's out there and whoever's right there, you know, we thoroughly hope you enjoy this piece. We're going to put our heart and souls into it. And I just want to say again, you know, thank you, everybody, for coming, making the effort to get out of the house. Not easy these days to get somebody out of the house, you know. It's like, so I recognize that it actually takes leaving the house and making an effort to come. So thank you so much. We feed off of your energy. It feels great. I hope you're feeding off of our energy. This is why live I love listening to music. I listen to music all day, but this is why actually seeing live music matters, because there's nothing like the exchange. So thank you. And here is our version of Len Boogsy Sharp's Misbehave.